Hi there, how's it going? This is Ash, and welcome to the last review at present of the Hornby Thomas and Friends range. This video is scheduled to be live on the 21st of December, so this will be the last review to come before Christmas of 2018. So that means I'm going to throw in a wee bit of fun for the test run of the train. This one is the Hornby R9048 Ben, as this is a follow-on video from the other twin of Bill. This one is in the older style box, as there is no information card that came with the model when I purchased it, and the model is a wee bit worn in some areas, such as the faded red line there. I may have a go at patching this up myself, but personally it's not a big deal. I've just bought this as a temporary measure. Well, I may go try and seek a mint version just for my collection, and I'll just use this for model railway clubs and train shows or something in the future. Anyways, as per the other review, there is no instructions included with this model, though the box does have a push-through hole on the back, so I can easily ease the model out. There is no coupling hooks on either end, so we'll have to make sure this is a solid connection between the test train and Ben, as there is no hook on either end, although it is an 040 model. And it does appear to have a lot of use, looking at the wheels. But I have given it a wee service just before doing this video, but I will do a couple of more test laps with a test train before I film the test run anyways. As with Bill, Ben's got the SCC lettering on the sides, complete with Ben's nameplate, although these are painted and not etched. General cab detailing, no interior or anything luxury like that. Just had to think of an appropriate word. It is a metal frame, as you can see by some of the paint that has peeled off there, but that could be the reason why I got this model quite cheap, because of its condition, but it's a start anyways. And you have got the same motor as used by Bill and Toby. And that is all there is really to cover in the unboxing part of this video. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to place that onto the track, and then I'm going to close the video temporarily until I've repositioned the camera, and I will commence with a test run with a rather funny test train. All will be revealed soon. Slight change of plans here, as unfortunately I was going to throw in something special for a wee bit of fun, but that didn't work out too well, as unfortunately the special passenger that was going to be riding or surfing this Thomas train sadly doesn't quite clear the loading gauge. Although that reminds me, these models of Bill and Ben and Toby are quite large models for 00 gauge, so you may have to be careful and potentially check track clearances on either side of the track, especially on curved sections, as these models are prone to catching blindside objects if they are too close, as these models are more to 1:64 scale as opposed to 1:76. But they are 00 gauge nonetheless. So anyways, as with the Bell review, I'm going to apply some power, as I've tested Ben with the what would have been the surprise train. But I will do some special fun videos in 2019 once I get some more track, as I shouldn't have any problems with clearances once I have more track to play with. But anyways, that's all I'm going to say for now. I'm just going to reach over and turn on the train controller. Unlike Bill, Ben doesn't have any coupling hooks, so I'm having to rely on the coupling hooks on the troublesome trucks to maintain a continuous coupling. So I may have to reach for the controller quickly if Ben decides to ditch his freight train. That said, despite the condition of Ben, the model is still a very nice runner. And apart from the slight fading of the red band around his boiler, the model is still in very good condition anyways. And I will seek some coupling hooks for him anyways. Or I may buy a mint condition version of Ben to add to my collection. I'll just use this one for general running really. As today is the 21st of December, as this video should be live then, as I'm still recovering from one of them super bugs, and I've just recently got my voice back, I do hope to be much better when I do reviews after the Christmas holiday season. And for the time being, I have to say this will be the very last of the Hornby Thomas and Friends reviews that I will be doing. Well, it may not be the last model train review to come of 2018, but it definitely will be the last Thomas and Friends reviews of the Hornby range for now. As always, I do appreciate all positive and constructive feedback on the content I create. Until next time, take care, keep well, keep warm, have a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year for 2019. Well, there will be another review of a model train to probably come. It'll be around the 28th of December. Although the question is if I would be sober enough to do it properly is another matter. But that said, I just want to say to all of you, thank you for watching and Merry Christmas. Cheerio.